गुड मॉर्निंग साफिया।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
मुनीर, व्हाई नाउडेज योर कैमरा इज ऑफ यूजुअली? इज देयर सम प्रॉब्लम? देन स्विच इट ऑन ना। Okay, Safiya, did you try the circuit making of
circuit
last time at home? Did you try? Did you try making it at home? Muni, did you try?
Ma'am, I need cell for it. I have everything else.
You have everything?
I have wires.
Okay, you have cells and a bulb. These three things minimum you require.
No, I need cell and bulb.
Okay. You have at home, you use that table clocks are there, na? So cells are there in table clocks. You use the cell, same cell you can use. Okay. You don't have table clock. Okay, so you can buy it from you can buy cell from any stationery shop nearby.
Yeah, I have one.
Ma'am, I need that on top wala thing.
Top wala thing. Okay. See, if all of you are interested, we can make different circuits. I wanted to make series and parallel circuit, but only if all of you bring the things. Then only we
can.
Ma'am,
I have to ask my father again that if he have it or not.
Oh, that is fine. You can bring simple cells, Safiya. Okay, that way also we can do.
Speed bulb, then I'll do it.
You'll do it. Okay, let us ask others also if they are interested. Actually, I wanted to show you, but you need two bulbs for that. That day I could not show. Everyone has not joined yet. Let us wait. Did you understand what we did in the previous class? Those who are there in the class can answer. Muneeb, I can only
yes.
See Muneeb and Safiya. Farhana, Saklain, Umaira, Amina, they're not yet ready for the class. Farhana, are you there?
Mama, I guess she can on her video.
Okay, Muneeb, you tell me what we did. What did you learn in the previous class? What did you do?
Mama, about electricity and current.
Yes.
Current electricity.
Yes, we learned about current electricity. What else? How we learned about?
Well, today what are we going to learn about? Today what are we going to learn about?
Different types of circuit.
Yeah, Saklain, what is saying? Saklain, I'm not audible to you. Saklain, just try to rejoin. Try to log in and log out. Log out and log in. And then see whether you're able to hear. Okay. Okay, rest everyone has joined. Ahmed, have you come back? Are you there, Ahmed? Amina, still having
breakfast?
What are you eating?
Roti and sabji.
Yes, Amina?
Roti and sabji.
Roti, sabji, okay. Okay, finish it. But don't be in a hurry. Chew properly and eat, okay? Eating should be done in a relaxed way. You have read digestive system, right? Okay, so we were doing what we did in the last class. Humaira, please switch on your camera. Just for a moment you switched on and then you are back again. Yeah, what we did, Humaira, in the last class, what did you understand from the previous class? The demonstration of electrical circuits. What did you understand from that? Unmute, Humaira. Unmute yourself and answer. Anything you can say, whatever you saw, whatever you understood from the previous class, just put it in your own words and answer. There is no correct and wrong answer for this, okay?
Ma'am, we learned about the circuit. Okay. You showed us an activity. So, if a good conductor and a bad conductor, so yes, if you attach a good conductor to it,
yes,
so electricity passes through it.
Okay.
The bad conductor, it doesn't pass through it, and if any thing is missing, so a circuit is not complete.
Excellent, Humaira. Yeah, we did only these things. When the circuit is open, current will not flow through the circuit. When you put a conductor in through the circuit, there will be flow of current and the circuit will be complete. When you put an insulating material, again, the circuit will be incomplete and there will not be any current through the circuit. So basically, we studied all these things using the circuit, making of circuit, and we did. Saklin, now I am audible to you. Am I audible, Saklin? I think still Saklin is having problem. Okay, Ahmad. Just switch on your camera, Ahmad. Yeah. Hello, good morning. Okay. Okay, so yeah, last time, now what I wanted to tell you, see, if all of you bring the component, circuit components, we can have another activity. I wanted to show you a series and parallel circuit combination with the help of same components should be there. If you are ready, all of you, if you are able to bring it, then we'll show it. Otherwise, I'll do it on the slide also. So tell me, are you going to bring it? We can have it on Wednesday class, next Wednesday class or Monday class. You can tell me. Okay, still you're not able to. I can see the gray screen only. Just let me ask him. Saklin is having problem with. I think Saklin is having problem. Okay, you tell me. All of you, just tell me yes or no. Amina, will you be able to bring the connecting wires, two bulbs? And I think four batteries will be required, or two batteries also is fine. Will you be able to bring?
Yes, ma'am. Can you just add what you have to bring in the Google Classroom? Or
I sent it last time also. You have the list now? I'll add. You don't need so many things now. Now you know how to make a circuit, right? You got an idea how to connect and how to make a circuit. You saw it yesterday class. So will you be comfortable making it, all of you? Amina, you'll be able to bring?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Humaira, will you be able to bring?
Ma'am, by next Wednesday.
Ma'am,
yes,
you just need to send the... Can you send the materials in the Google Classroom?
I'll send it, but you
can... Or to my father privately.
Yeah?
Or to my father privately, also you can send.
No, I'll send it in Google Classroom only so that everyone can know what to bring. Because I wanted to show you a certain type of circuit. So when you see a simple, if you are able to make a simple circuit also, you can make that circuit also.
So,
but only thing is you need two bulbs. Munir, will you be able to bring? Will you be able to bring?
I don't know about the bulb, but everything else I can bring.
You have already. Small bulbs you need. I think a 3-volt bulb is there. You can bring two bulbs because we need two bulbs for that. Okay?
I will try.
Ahmad, you already have, so you can bring Ahmad for the class. Yes. Saklin, are you there now? Muazzam Mudabbir. Muazzam Mudabbir, are you there in the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, is switch on your camera?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so I was asked, did you hear? What did I ask them? Will you be able to bring the circuit components in Wednesday's class? We want to make another circuit. If you are able to bring everyone, if you are able to bring it, we'll do it so that you also do, and I'll explain how to do it. Otherwise, if you are not, if it's not possible for you to bring, we can have it on the slide and I'll draw it on the slide and we can do that way also. So you tell me, Farhana, will you be able to do?
I'm going to have to check if it's available.
Yeah, Mina?
I have to check if it is going to be available.
It is available everywhere. In any stationery shop or hardware shop, you'll get it. You just ask the electrical, for electrical project or electrical experiment I want, the connecting wires. You can take 2 meters connecting wire. See, 1 meter connecting wire is 5 rupee only. So you can take 2 meters connecting wire. Muazzam and Mudabbir can do it together only. Together they can do, okay? You don't need to do separately. So at a place, just do it together only. If you want to do, we can have it in the class or I can show you through the video also. So you tell me. You can decide and you can tell me in the next class also. Fine? Okay, everyone?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so let us now start with our class. We did electrical circuits, open circuit, closed circuit, and conductors, role of conductor and insulator in the electrical circuit. Everything, this is clear to you all. Amina, it's clear to you? When conductor is there in the circuit, how does the circuit behave? Is there a current in the circuit or not? When insulator is there in the circuit, will the circuit work? Will the bulb glow when the insulator is connected in the circuit?
No,
it will not glow. Why? Because? Why? Why, Amina?
Because normally insulator does not provide light.
No, insulator does not provide the path for electrons to flow. Insulator does not allow electrons to flow through them. Okay, so that is why. Okay, I gave you one question. Anybody remembers what was the question in the class? I gave you one question.
Why copper is used in wires?
No. Question also you forgot? Everyone has forgotten the question? This is very bad. Nobody remembers what question I gave you. One question I gave you and I told you that I will ask you this question. It was related to metals.
Ma'am, you asked why metals are good conductors of electricity?
Yes, excellent, Muazzam. This was my question. Why metals are good conductors of electricity? Anybody has found the answer? No, nobody remembers the question. I'm not giving you this answer. Now, next class, again, I want this answer. Okay? Fine. Can you write down this question so that you don't forget, everyone? Please write down this question. Why metals are good conductors of electricity? Everyone, write down. Muneeb written question. Please write down the question. Why metals are good conductors of electricity? You need to find out the answer. If you know the answer right now also, you can say.
I can say?
Yes. Yes, Muneeb.
Metals are good conductors because in wires, the electrons which are there, they go from the inside, but in metals, the outer electrons are not belong to the metal. It is belong to a cloud something, but the electrons are not like they are not no with no they are no longer with atom.
Actually, they are there with the atom. What do you call that outermost electrons of metals? What do you call that?
Cloud.
It's not cloud. Anybody knows? What do you call outermost electrons of a conductor?
Loose electron.
It is free electrons. Okay? Free electrons are the they are loosely bound, but the term is called as free electrons. Okay? So the electrons which are loosely bound are lying in the outermost shell of. I think you have to move. Everyone, please mute yourself. Still, I'm getting a background.
She doesn't smile anymore. And because of that, the entire kingdom becomes
strong. You need to mute.
Next on
her. Safiya, can you make me the host? So that I can also mute. Yeah, now it is fine. Yeah. Okay. So, free electrons are the electrons which are present in the outermost shell of an atom. Okay? So, metals have got few
electrons. I need to make you the host, right?
Yeah. Okay. So, these are called as free electrons. But still, I want complete answer. Anyone has found a complete answer? Thank you, Safiya. Anyone knows the answer? The answer is on the correct track. The loosely bound electrons are the reason for metals to be a good conductor. But what happens in insulator? Insulator is made up of what material?
Ma'am, can I say the answer?
Yes, yes, Monique.
Why metals are good conductor of electricity?
Yes, yes, Monique. Tell me.
Ma'am, electric current is a flow of electrons in wire. In metals, the outer electrons of the atom belong to a cloud of decollized electrons. They are no longer firmly held by a specific atom, but instead they can move freely through the lattice of positive metal ions.
Okay.
Metals are good conductors of heat also.
Okay, you're reading, Muneeb. Do you understand?
Ma'am, can I say?
Structure? You need to put it in your own words because this is a little higher level. You will not understand it. Yes, Farhana, you tell me.
Ma'am, metals are good conductors of electricity because they have free electrons. These free electrons act as a charge carriers in the metallic structure.
Yes. See, because they have free electrons. Now, what is a structure? I'll just show you the structure of... structure of atom has got, this is a nucleus. Nucleus has got protons and neutrons in the nucleus. And you have got electrons in the outermost shell like this. For example, if I take sodium, sodium has got how many electrons? Do you know how many electrons are there in sodium? Sodium has got 11 electrons. And how are they arranged? They are arranged in the innermost shell. There are two electrons. Only two electrons will be there in the innermost shell. Okay, first shell, only two electrons are possible. Then in the second shell, there will be 8 electrons. Because?
Then it gives one to the other element.
That is later on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. But still, total electrons are 11. So it has got only one electron in the outermost shell. Only one electron. This electron, you can see from the center, this is positively charged center. This is positive charge and the electron is negative charge. Because the distance is maximum, this electron is loosely bound. Rest of the electrons are bound towards the nucleus and they are bound by a strong force of attraction because positive nucleus and negative electron. So you have a strong force of attraction. Unlike charge attract each other. But here the outermost shell, that means it is at a larger distance. So it is loosely bound. And because it is loosely bound, So in the metal, what happens? So many atoms are there. This is one atom I have drawn. if you take a sodium metal, it has got so many atoms. These are all atoms, okay? And the outermost electron is loosely bound. So what happens? It comes out of the atom. It comes out of the atom, but it does not come out of the metal. It will not come out of the metal unless you give some energy to it. So these free electrons move inside the metal. They are moving randomly, okay? Some of so many atoms are there and so many free electrons are there. So they are moving randomly inside the metal. But what happens when you touch a metal? Do you get a shock? Do you get an electric shock when you touch a metal?
Only few.
No, you don't get na. When there is no current, when there is no battery, you don't get a shock. But still, the electrons are moving inside. And you know that whenever the electrons
are together, so we get shock and all, but when they move freely, we don't get, right?
Yes, they are moving randomly, so that is why you don't get shock, because the average velocity becomes zero. In all different directions, the free electrons are moving. So that is why you don't get a shock. But if I connect a battery to this, if I connect a cell or battery to this conductor,
the battery holds all that cells inside.
This is positive terminal of the battery. This is negative terminal of the battery. What will happen? These electrons are negatively charged. So all these will start moving in orderly motion like this. Instead of moving randomly, all of them will start moving in one direction. Okay? So now the current flows, and current is always opposite to the direction of current. To the direction of electron. So current flows from here and electron flows from here in this way. Because this is a negative charge, so electron will flow from here, comes back like this. So now the circuit is complete, and if you touch the conductor now, you will get an electric shock. Is it clear? So this is the reason why conductors allow electricity to flow through them, because they have free electrons. And free electrons means all the metals will have electrons, either one or two or three electrons in the outermost shell. Then only it is a metal.
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes. Yes, Ahmed. What is your question?
You said there is a force of attraction between the nucleus and the electron.
Correct.
So over time, why don't the electrons thus merge with the nucleus?
Electron does not merge inside the nucleus. This is when you go in higher classes, 11th standard, this initially the theory was that electrons are moving in shell, okay? Moving in orbits. But later on, when the scientists studied, they were told that these are orbitals. And whenever electrons jump to outer shell, they release energy, and they jump to inner shell, whenever they jump to outer shell, they take energy, and jump to inner shell, they give out energy. So in this way, this atom will never collapse. You are saying collapsing, na? They should collapse. But it never happens like this. There is a stability in it, okay? When Rutherford, so many atomic model was given. You know, first model of atom was given by Dalton. Then Thomson also said. Then Rutherford gave you one structure of atom. And then finally, Bohr gave. So Bohr's structure of atom was the correct one. And because till now, it is the correct one. Later on, if somebody else discovers that, no, this doesn't happen. So, but till now, we are studying with Bohr's atomic structure. Okay, so this will never collapse, because there is energy exchange taking place always. And also, because of the distance, the force of attraction is least in the outermost shell. When you see, you remember a magnet. A magnet is there, a magnetic material is there. It will attract it. When I move it away, at a certain point, the magnetic field is not there. This substance will not face the magnetic field and it will not get attracted. Is it clear? So same thing happens over here. Electrostatic force of attraction is also like the magnetic force of attraction. So outermost electron, it is loosely bound. So it is loosely attached to the nucleus. And that is why it easily comes out of the atom. When it comes out of the atom, it is free to move inside the conductor. It is freely moving. But when I see, just remember, when there is no teacher in the class, how do you behave in the class? Somebody is standing on the bench, somebody is throwing paper, somebody is moving here and there. You do like this only when no teacher is there in the class, right? So all the students, suppose they are electrons, they are moving randomly in the class. Suddenly a teacher comes, which is our cell. When the teacher comes, what happens? Everybody go and sit at their appropriate place. Right? This happens orderly movement. So same happens over here also. In this classroom, when this battery is attached, because of this positive terminal of the battery, electrons are negatively charged. They start moving in the orderly fashion and they start moving in particular direction. And because of the orderly movement of electrons, you get a current in the circuit. Okay? We studied in the circuit.
Question, ma'am.
Yes, Murib, ask your question.
Ma'am, when you put a conductor into wires and like in the circuit, you put a spoon, no? In last
yes.
time.
Yes, yes.
So, ma'am, if you put that for a long time and then when you hold a spoon, will you get a shock?
If the battery is of higher magnitude, I can get a shock. But my battery is very, that day also I told you, my battery was just 3 volt. So, you will not feel the shock. Is it clear? But you get the shock when you put a conductor inside a plug point and with your naked hand, if you touch it with switch on, you will get a shock. And that is a fatal shock. Sometimes we get shock in rainy season. Now you remember you touch the metallic covering of fridge or sometimes you get a shock suddenly. Not a big shock, but you get sometimes shock whenever there is a leakage or something current is there in your circuit. Okay. Is it clear, Muneeb? Anybody has doubt why metals are good conductors of electricity? Now, this was the answer for why metals are good conductors of electricity. But what happens in insulators or non-metals? Do you have any example of an insulator? Chloride is an insulator. Chlorine is a non-metal. So, it is an insulator, right? How many electrons are there? Let me raise this first. In chlorine, I'll take another non-metal. Let us take a smaller metal. Boron, after boron, what is it? Oxygen, nitrogen. These are all gases only. Okay, so let us take a... chlorine is how many electrons are there?
17, man.
Correct, 17. Do you know the electronic structure? 2, 8 and 7. That means first shell has got 2 electrons. Always there will be 2 electrons in the first shell. Second shell has got 8 electrons. And the last shell has got 7 electrons. Now, 7 electrons is not the free electrons. Why? Because taking out 7 electrons is very difficult and it needs lot of energy. So many electrons are there, 7 electrons will not come out. Balki, what happens
if that is... How will you find the electron of a gas?
All gas, solid or liquid, all of them are made up of atoms. And atoms will have number of electrons.
No, ma'am, how will we find like... In this we find now. So how will we find in them in gases?
You already know now. 17 you already know. So you know
that. No, man, not like that.
Then?
Like if it's a gas like nitrogen.
Who is this killer? Can you see over here?
No, ma'am.
I can see now.
I can also see someone is there with killer wave.
Yes. He's not from our class, na?
Mom, I don't know.
Yes, ma'am. I can also see.
Ma'am, everybody is there from our class.
Except for killer.
So I'm removing him, okay? I'm removing this person, killer. Everyone is there, na? Nobody is missing. Just check. Saklin, I cannot contact him.
Ma'am, nobody is missing.
Nobody is missing now, so I removed him. Okay. Okay, so outermost shell, you have got 7 electrons. So no free electrons are here. When there is no free electrons, it will not allow. So what will flow? There is nothing to flow through this. So you will have I just gave you an example of gas. But in non-metals, any solid non-metals, can you name any solid non-metal? Any solid non-metal also will be like, you just see this analogy only works. Wood is a non-metal, but you don't know its electronic structure, right? So I'm just telling you that this is a non-metal, and non-metals are bad conductor of electricity because they don't have free electrons to move. Because only when free electrons are there, they will only move in the circuit, right? They are responsible for the flow of current. When there is no free electron, then nothing is there to move. So from here to here, no electron motion will take place, and that is why there is no path for electrons to move. No free electrons, so what will move? Nothing will move. So that is why there is no current in flow insulator. So insulator does not.
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes, yes, Ahmed.
When sodium or any metal conducts electricity.
Yes.
When the atoms leave and come, when the electrons leave and come.
Electrons leave and come means like this, right?
So wouldn't that change the chemical structure of the atom?
Yes.
Chemical, okay, yes. That also what happens, I'm telling you, when, I'm just making it 281, okay? I'm taking it a metal. So it is 281. So that means you said that one electron comes out, right? What happens when one electron comes out? This is one electron, 281. So this one electron moves out. When from the atom, one electron has come out. Now, this atom is no longer neutral because earlier it had equal number of protons and equal number of neutrons, right? It had, what was it? 11 protons in the center and 11 electrons, so which made atom neutral. But when one electron comes out of this atom, now this is no longer an atom. This is called as a positively charged ion. Let me write it over here. Eraser. Now this is called as, when one negative is out, now this atom. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Man, do control, right?
281 was there. This electron has come out, okay? Now this electron has come out, so negative charge has come out. So this has more positive charge. Why? Because it has got 11 proton. It has got 11 proton, but 10 electron, correct? Is it clear? Do you agree with me in this? This is a sodium atom. This was a sodium atom. Now when? Yeah, this was a sodium atom, but when one electron comes out, now it has got more proton and less neutron. So this is called as Na plus. It has become a positively charged ion. Now it is a positively charged ion because it has got more positive charge than the negative charge. So it is a positively charged ion, and positively charged ion is called as cation. You remember when I was telling you about salt water, and I said that salt water is good conductor of electricity, whereas solid salt is not a good conductor of electricity. Why?
Will we take the neon element?
Let me explain what happens in salt water. In salt water, you have, because NaCl in water is there, what happens? NaCl gets separated into Na plus and Cl minus. Na plus and Cl minus. Okay. Why Cl minus? Because Cl has got 2, 8 and 7 electrons. Is this thing clear to you? 17 electrons are there in chloride.
Ma'am, this thing you know for even number, because here you took the numbers, all of them are odd, like 17, 11, they are odd numbers.
That is why I am just explaining you, taking one example, Safiya. Okay? So this is 287 chlorine, this is 281 sodium. Now this will take one electron to attain a stable configuration. You know what is stable configuration? 8 electrons should be there in the outermost shell. That is why this gave one electron. And chlorine will take this one electron from sodium. okay? Because sodium is giving one electron, so chlorine will take one electron and it becomes 2H8. So because it is having now extra electrons, so that is why chlorine is now negatively charged, and which is called as anion. So negatively charged ion is called as anion. Now you have got in salt solution, you have positive ion and negative ion. So if you connect this thing to a battery, this salt solution, what happens? And through a bulb will glow. Why? Because positive ion, now here movement is taking place. Positive ion will move towards negative terminal of battery, and negative ion will move towards positive terminal of battery. And this way motion is taking over here. So this is behaving like a conductor. Is it clear why salt solution was acting as a conductor? Because here also motion is taking place. Positively charged ion, sodium ion, is going towards the negative terminal of battery, and here chloride ion is going towards the positive terminal of the battery. So here you have movement of ions taking place. And in conductors, we had movement of electrons taking place. You remember? So that is why conduction is going on in salt water. Whereas in salt, if you take a powdered salt, it will not get separated into Na plus and Cl minus. Is it clear? In water only it gets separated. In separation is called as dissociation. Actually, sodium chloride is dissociating into sodium ions and chloride ions. And how it is dissociating? Sodium is giving its outermost electron to chloride, and chloride is taking this electron because it wants to attain a stable configuration. Stability is when outermost shell has got 8 electron, that is the stability. Is this clear? This is a little bit of basic chemistry, but you need to understand for this. Is it clear, Ahmed?
Yes. Ma'am, I have another question.
Yes.
Can a metal take an electron from another type of metal? Can iron take an electron from copper?
Nahi. It will not happen on its own. See, metals are good conductor of electricity, but you know that metal has got free electrons, right? But they reside inside the surface only, inside the metal surface only. But suppose if I give them a little heat, okay? So sometimes what happened, electrons are ejected out also from the surface of metal. This is called as electron emission. Emission of electrons from the surface of metal. But you need some form of energy to fall on this. It can be heat energy, light energy. If light energy falls and electrons are emitted, it is called as photoelectric emission. And if energy comes on and electrons are emitted, because why? Electrons need energy to move. So you can provide energy in any form, in the form of heat, in the form of light. And which form you are giving this energy, in an electron can move out from the metal surface also. And it is called as emission of electron. Okay, this happens in older generation TV. You remember older generation TV used to be a small TV, piche se back mein aisa hota tha, like that. Big TVs were there earlier. I don't know, you, we thought flat TV and flat screens are there. But earlier they used cathode ray tubes in TV. And in cathode ray tube, you had this electron emission taking place by heating. Okay, that was the concept. But that was very space consuming, and that is why nowadays you have a better TVs now. Yes, Farhana, you had some question?
Ma'am, can this electrons move if the metal sticks to a magnet? So
I didn't understand. Just repeat.
Look, if I stick a magnet to a metal, so will the electrons go to the magnet?
No, electrons will not go to the magnet. When you stick magnet, you can remove it also, but electrons are not coming out of the metal. Okay, they can just orient, they can just move inside. They get attracted because of the magnetic property. This is a different thing. This is not electrical property. Magnet attracts a metal towards itself because magnet attracts magnetic material. So magnetic material mein metals are there. So that is why it gets attracted towards the magnet. Okay. So that is a different thing. We are doing electric thing. Okay. Anyone else has doubt? Any doubt? No? Fine? Okay. So we'll come back to our topic now. Eraser. Wait, it's not erasing. Who was that killer? Huh? Anybody's brother or sister to nahi tha? Okay, so let us start with our this thing, electricity word search. Can you find out, just annotate and give me the words. Everyone, but do use different colors so that I can understand. Can you find? Yes, this is resistor. Who has found resistor? Blue color?
I'm V.
Okay, fuse. Who has found fuse? Okay, first, what is this one? Thermistor?
Ma'am, it's thermistor.
Yes, thermistor. Okay, electron is correct. Current also you got, voltmeter. Others also I want answer. Yes, Muneet, which answer you gave?
Voltmeter.
Voltmeter, okay. Only yellow and blue answers I'm getting. Rest also, find out. Switch. Yes, who got switch and diode? Who got switch and diode?
Ma'am, me.
Okay, Farhana. Find out wire. Where is wire? Okay, what is it? LAMP, lamp. Yes, lamp is there. What is it? Lamp we have got. Wire is there. Yes, Muneeb, you got wire?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Resistance is there. What else? Charge. Anybody has got charge?
Shruti, ma'am, I found cell, the purple one.
Charge is done, ma'am.
Yes, you got cell, correct. And this is what? Live wire. Yes, live. Who is red?
Ma'am, me.
Humaira, okay. Amina, which color you are using?
I'm using red, ma'am.
You are using red. Humaira, what? Which color?
Ma'am, I found the lamp one, red.
Ma'am, I have found the red one. The light.
Okay, this is one. Yes, thin red. Okay, what else? Abdullah, Ahmad, not found.
Ma'am. Wait, I got one.
Charge, battery, yes. Battery.
I got one.
What is left now? Resistance gone. Neutral is left. Neutral.
Earth is left.
Neutral is left.
Ma'am, we found neutral.
You found, where is neutral? Uh-huh. Okay, yes. Neutral is found, yes. Muazzam Mudabbir has found. Voltmeter, have you found voltmeter?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, yes, voltmeter also gone.
I found everything.
I found voltmeter.
Yes, earth is not done. Earth?
Ma'am, wait. I know where is it. E A.
Where is it, Safiya?
Wait.
Yes, earth is also found. So, all done. Okay, next class, let me stop sharing because 5 minutes is there. I'll just do with this textbook part.
So we need to remove our textbooks.
Bring your textbooks. Huh? I'll just give you the questions that questions based on the circuit we did. Bring your textbooks. Page number 76. Page number 76.
1 minute.
Yeah.
Page number
76. I'll be sending you the things required for circuit on Google Classroom. If you are able to find it, you can reply me on Wednesday, on Monday's class. Okay, so that we'll decide whether we'll do it on Wednesday or not.
Another
circuit, yes, with two bulbs now, series and parallel.
Repeat the question again.
Can you please repeat?
What? Page number 76. All of you have taken out page number 76. Muneeb, you're back. Ahmad, have you brought the textbook? Okay, page number 76. You can see the diagram on left hand side. Battery, bulb, everything is given. You have to label the diagram. All of you can label it.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm not doing it. Do this on your own. And this part also on right hand side page. Insulators, think about your observations, which materials are insulator. Okay, so we did this activity. Now think which objects were insulator and write down in this block. Okay, and the wires in the circuit you are using are covered in plastic. Why? Answer is given, plastics are insulator, so that is why they have given the answer also, so that is fine. Now next page, number 78. The questions which I am doing, you have to write the answer at home. Okay, I'm just discussing the question, but write it down at home. On page number 79, question number
78, what one?
78, you don't need to do anything. Just go through the chapter, read the chapter. It is written, whatever we have done, that is only written here. Can you explain, page number 79, question is, can you explain why an electrical circuit is called a circuit? Okay, you have to find the answer and write the answer. Okay, if you don't find it, answer, we can have it in next class. Can you predict, think about your and suggest any material from your investigation that will make good insulators? You can do that. Acha, good, Umaira, you have read the chapter, then you can do it on your own, okay? What happens if the wire to your teacher's computer breaks? Why is it important to use the correct type of wire to mend your teacher's computer? What will you say? What happens if the wire to your teacher's computer breaks?
If the wire of the teacher's computer breaks, then ma'am, the computer won't work.
Computer won't work, okay?
Because for the computer to work, it needs current, and if the wire breaks, the current circuit won't be complete, and then that's why it won't work.
Correct, Safiya. The current circuit is not complete, so it will not work.
So we have to write this in the notebook, ma'am.
No, write it in the book only. The space is provided in the textbook. Write it in the textbook only, okay? So all these three questions will be done. Next class, I will ask you, don't upload it on Google Classroom. I'll just show me like this. I'll see whether you have written the answer or not. Okay. Okay. Now next page number 80. 81. Leave 81. Till 78 only you do. Okay. Great, Muneeb. You have also done till page 79. You complete the question and read till page 81. Okay. Fine.
Until 80, right?
Till 80, you read the chapter.
Yes, ma'am.
You read the chapter because ammeter, voltmeter, all those things I want to explain. What are these things? So next class, we'll be doing that. And for activity, just see whether you can get those things or not. Otherwise, we can do it on the slide on also. Okay? Fine. So see you in the maths class now. Bye, everyone.
Bye. Bye, ma'am.